I'm Agent Yang, and today I'm going to show you how to set up a Roku Streaming Stick Plus. Here's what you'll need. A high-speed network so you can stream high-quality content without interruptions. The username and password to that wireless network. The TV instruction manual. A smartphone or tablet with the Roku app installed, or a computer where you can log in or create a Roku account. Later in the video, I'll show you how to use the Roku app on your smart device as the remote control. All right, let's get started. First, connect the Roku player to an available HDMI port on your TV. If possible, it should be a port that supports HDCP 2.2, so that you can get both 4K and high dynamic range content when you're streaming, if your TV supports those options. If not, see if you have an HDMI 2.0, which will support high dynamic range. You can find this information in your TV's instruction manual. Now, plug the included USB cable into the mini USB port on the Roku player. Make sure you use the cable that came with your Roku player, because there's a long-range wireless receiver built in. If your TV has an available USB port, you can plug the cable into that. Or you could use the included AC adapter and plug it into an outlet, which is what I'll do. Power on the TV and switch the input to the HDMI port that your Roku player is plugged into. You'll see either a Roku logo, a language selection screen, or a screen asking to pair the remote. Now, before you pair the remote, open the back cover and install the included batteries. When you put the cover back on, the pairing process should automatically begin. If not, press this button in the battery compartment of the remote, and the screen will show that it's pairing. Once that's done, choose your language and press OK. Your Roku will now automatically scan for available Wi-Fi networks. Highlight the right one with your remote by using the directional pad and press OK. Then, using that same directional pad, type in your network's password and then tap OK. Once your Roku player is connected to your network, it will check to see if there are any available updates. If there are, select OK to install them. This could take a while, and your Roku player might need to restart afterwards. If it does, the screen might go black for a short amount of time, and then it'll come back to the Set Display Type screen. Select Auto Detect Display Type, then press OK so the Roku player can analyze the quality of your HDMI port and TV resolution. The screen will go black for a few seconds, and then you'll see the settings that the Roku player will be using. If these don't look right, move the Roku player to a different HDMI port, and then select, I've changed something, retry. Otherwise, if it does look right, select OK, go to automatic. The screen will change and ask if it looks OK. If it does, we'll keep moving through the setup process. Take a closer look at your Roku's remote control, which has the power button at the top and center, and volume buttons on the side. Now we'll make sure it's working right. Choose Check Remote Settings. At this point, the Roku player will play some music to see if you can hear it. If you can, select Yes, music is playing. On the other hand, if you can't, select No so your Roku player can reconfigure. The next screen will ask if the music has stopped playing. Mine did, so I'll choose Yes. Once your remote is working, you'll see this success message. Your remote is now programmed. You'll also be reminded to point the remote at the TV in order for it to work properly. Next, continue to follow the on-screen instructions to complete the setup process. If you need to create a Roku account, go through the prompts. When you're done, log in. You'll notice channels compatible with your Roku account will now be synced across all your devices, so streaming on different ones will be easy. Your TV screen will change as your Roku player adjusts according to your preferences. After a few minutes, you'll see All Done on the screen. Then, press the right arrow on the directional pad of the Roku player's remote, which will take you to your home screen. There, you'll find your apps and channels. And that means your new Roku player is ready. But if you've got a few minutes, now's a great time to get familiar with your Roku app, which has extra functions, like being able to use the app as a remote control, private listening through headphones, and streaming media from your device to your Roku player. To access these great features, sign into the app and press Continue. If you're interested in streaming TV shows with the Roku channel, tap on Next. Otherwise, tap Skip. Now, tap on the account icon in the top right corner of the screen, next to the search bar, and choose Sign In. Enter the same account information that you used to set up the Roku player. And once you're signed in, tap the back arrow at the top left of the screen. Then tap on Remote at the bottom of the screen and choose the Roku player that you want to control through the app. You might end up getting more than one. Now you can use your app for extra functionality and to control your Roku player. And here's a tip. If you're not having success using the app to control your new player, double check that your smart device is connected to the same wireless network as your Roku player. Otherwise, have fun and happy streaming. Hopefully this video was helpful. If it was, give it a like. If you have questions, let us know in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more tech tips from Best Buy. Thanks for watching.